Jealousy is not a proper excuse, dear, for not sharing your concern for my life.
On the contrary, Alan, jealousy is the only acceptable excuse in such matters. Now, if you can only find a way out of this place.
I think we'll have more love in the daylight. Here, lay your head down on the suitcase.
I'm much too frightened to sleep.
Don't worry, I won't let anything happen to you.
My great and wonderful Alan, my guardian angel.
Thank you. last chance we have of getting out alive.
Spiders only come out at night.
Yes?
So if we continue walking, we're liable to run into one.
But if we wait here, we'll be eaten by giant spiders.
Look around you, Rodrigo. Do you see any spiders?
No.
Remember the old bandage? A spider in the hand is worth two in the bush. So let's catch them shut up.
Right here looks pretty good.
Yes, this is soft enough. Try not to make too much noise. You remember how they hurt my ears? Rodrigo, stop making all that racket!
I'm sorry, Pedro.
Rodrigo, if you can't control your snoring, go sleep over there.
I'm not snoring, Pedro. I'm not even asleep.
Well, then who is?
Did your pillow just move?
Rodrigo, don't be silly. Pillow. Ah, there's not that. Rodrigo, let's get out of here.
Work, work, another year, another Christmas. Work, work. all over the world for your toys, ma'am. We wouldn't want to fail a single one. I was thinking out loud just the other day, ma'am, that if we shipped our toys twice a week instead of twice a month, we could reach twice as many boys and twice as many girls.
Oh, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am?
If you would talk half as much, half the time, you would have half as many bad boys.
Yes, ma'am. I was only thinking, ma'am.
Put your time to better use, for me, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
I will stop back in 20 minutes to check on your product. Don't.
Ma'am, it would be a disappointment for me to disappoint you.
Not another word, Romeo.
Yes, ma'am.
Romeo, get to work.
Sorry, ma'am, I couldn't help it.
Get to work, now.
Now, where was I? Oh, yeah. One white rabbit and one brown teddy bear. For my, word border, replace white fur and brown hair on rabbit and bear before December 7th ship date.
Release her!
Of course! Are you a robber?
No, but if you call for help, I'll have no other choice than to defend myself.
Us, dear.
Us.
And who are you defending yourselves from? I can promise you I have a menacing bone in my body. The Master Toymaker solves that.
The Master Toymaker? How is that if we made it? We're safe! We're in Toyland!
How can you be sure?
Well, you do our best to conceal it, but the toys are a dead giveaway.
Nice to meet all of you. I'm sorry, but we can't be too careful. We're being pursued by my greedy Uncle Barnaby and two scoundrels intent on killing me and stealing my inheritance.
I see. Now, if it were me,
And then Uncle Barnaby is trying to force me to marry him by threatening to have my family and my mother thrown onto the street.
I see. Now, if someone would ask me what I would do in such a situation as I would...
But if only we could talk to the Master Toymaker, I know she can help us.
Of course, Master Toymaker.
Romeo, I forgot to mention that the routing number on the shipment has been changed to... Romeo, I don't remember any dogs in this nature on our order list.
They're not dogs, ma'am. They're people.
People? Real people?
Yes, ma'am. From...
Is this the Master Toymaker?
One and the same.
I'm so happy to finally meet you. And I'm pleased to meet you, but you have to go ahead. You don't need to go. I will go
ahead. Allow me to introduce myself.
Ourselves.
Ourselves. My name is Alan, and this is my fiancée, Mistress Mary Quite Contrary. We've come all the way from Mother Gooseland to escape my wicked Uncle Barnaby.
Who's trying to kill Alan for his inheritance and marry me. I couldn't think of anyone better to help us. Someone as wonderful as you can create such remarkable and lifelike dolls. There's a sense of wonder and magic here I've never even felt from Mother Gooseland.
Well, yes, it is magic. You see, the Master Toymaker...
Oh, ma'am, you talk to her.
That's not my fault, ma'am.
Well, yes. Yes, my dear. Toyland is a magical and mystical place. I love it here amongst my dolls and toys. But oh, how beautiful are you? You come from Charles Toyland to a ghost Toyland. But if you are lucky, you'll remember that Toyland belongs here between all of us.
Oh,
delicious. But I'm afraid when Uncle Barnaby finds out I escaped, he'll track us here and try to finish up the job himself.
Do you think he would follow you all the way to Twerk?
His greed will drive him to. Besides, he loves Mistress Mary. I don't expect him to give up so easily. I know I would.
Why must I be so pretty?
Ladies first.
that's necessary, dear ones.
On the contrary, my love, you wouldn't want me to arrive in England not fully dressed, now would you?
Of course not.
Well then.
The bonbons, if you should be so kind, Hermione.
As you wish, sir. Do you think we'll like England?
I will be happy anywhere as long as I'm with you. However, we need to keep our minds on the situation at hand. It might be safer if we wait inside the box.
But Alan, it's always stuffy in the box, and there's so much more to see out here.
But what if they come back?
They've already searched this place. There's many more places to look. They'd be idiots in wasting their time coming back here.
Rodrigo, where are you?
Consorgo!
Rodrigo!
I've been looking all over for you.
I didn't realize I was lost.
Where have you been?
All over there, under this and behind that.
Did you find anything?
You.
Besides that?
No, but look at this. No. Boy, oh boy, I wish I had a uniform like this.
Yeah, what a doll. I wouldn't mind taking this one on a late night cruise.
I want to stay here my whole life, Consorgo. I don't even like Mr. Barty. Do you?
Rodrigo, do you want to be rich?
I prefer happy.
Well, if we don't do what Mr. Barnaby says, then I'm afraid we'll find ourselves floating at the bottom of the sea. On the other hand, if we get rid of Alan so we can marry his sweetheart Mistress Mary and steal his inheritance, then we'll be set for life. Eureka! I'm going to rule the world! I'm going to rule the world! Are you all right, Mr. Barnaby?
I couldn't be better, boys. I've found the secret to life, and it's going to make me millions, millions.
Rodrigo, perhaps you're. I think he's gone mad.
Mad at this man.
Oh look, what a lovely doll. I used to love someone like you once,
but she was quite contrary. You, my dear, will never complain, no matter what I say or do.
Mr. Barnaby, and our dues. Baxter, I'm gonna have to ask you to unhand this dog now.
And all due respect, you idiot, I'm gonna have to ask you to step aside.
This drum majorette here is just the kind of high-stepping doll I want by my side, and I'm crowned King Barnaby.
King Barnaby?
You're right. Emperor Barnaby has a much better ring to it.
Are these people? Delicate, I believe, ma'am.
Oh, and I thought we had an understanding, Inspector. Pity. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this book holds the secret to making me the most rich and powerful man in the world, if not the universe.
Where did you find that?
Oh, over there, under this and behind that.
Why didn't you look behind that, Rodrigo?
I don't want to rule any of this, Inzorgo. I don't even want to freaking do any of this.
You want to stay here in Toyland, do you?
Yeah.
Better be careful what you wish for. Isn't that right, Master Toymaker?
I don't know what you mean.
Oh, of course you do. Your secret recipe is noted right here in this book, which you've been so kind to pass on to me. It says here that berries from Strawberry Knoll mixed with the mystical waters of Mulberry Lake are the secret power behind a magic machine that turns dolls into real people.
Did you hear that, Rodrigo? Doll into real people.
But I like the dolls better just the way they are. They're nicer than most people.
That's what makes Toyland so magical. The dolls are only one machine blast away from becoming real.
You should know, Romeo.
You really do talk too much.
I'm sorry, ma'am. You wanted someone to talk to. I saw to the order myself, ma'am. You were lonely here with all these dolls, so you made me real. And you specifically ordered a gentle assistant with an active voice box.
You mean you're one of them?
Hardly. Those dolls are really...
What is it, Grimmel?
Nothing, ma'am.
I find that hard to believe.
I was only going to say, ma'am, that those dolls are really scheduled to be shipped tonight. The shipping can't be late. Gotta get that drum major back into her box. I'll pack the captain with her, ma'am. Can't be late. No, no, no.
Not so fast. I'm in charge now. This is the last shipment out of Toyland, and it leaves when I'm ready.
I can't let you do that, sir.
I don't think you have a choice unless you like sniffing fire hydrants and flipping over trash cans.
Pardon?
Sorry, ma'am. You can't help it, Inspector. You're just a dumb animal.
I don't get it.
I don't expect you to get a Gensorgo. You're just a dumb animal yourself in another way.
Don't pay him any mind, Gensorgo. I think you're very smart.
Thank you, Rodrigo. I think you're smart, too. Your mental disability never fails to amaze me.
I rest my case.
Where are my children, you brute? I swear, if you've laid a hand on any single one of them, I'll chop you into bite-sized pieces and feed you to the sharks.
Oh, all that whining and wheezing and crying and complaining.
Don't talk about my precious darlings that way.
Your precious darlings? Madam, I was referring to you. No. Thanks to your little rugrats and nature's call, I've quite by accident discovered the secret recipe to creating the perfect child. I haven't heard a peep out of them. Not a whimper. Not since they were blasted with a bit of magic. I have a Christmas present out there for you. Grumio Holiday.
I don't take orders from you.
Now, if I understand correctly, the process is reversible. One blast from the machine and back you go in the box with all the other toys.
As he says, Grumio, he has the magic book.
You too, Inspector. You wouldn't want me to reverse any magic, would you?
Will someone please explain what's going on here?
My pleasure. Not only has the master toy maker here concocted a secret recipe that fuels a machine that breathes life into his creations, but he's also discovered a means to zap the life out of creatures.
Huh?
In other words, my bumbling imbeciles, he can turn real people into toys and live creatures, including toys, into humans.
I don't believe a word you say.
Oh, no. Why, it's recorded right here in this book. A little lost dog sniffed his way into a magic machine and turned himself into a stuffed animal. That's how you found out it works both ways, didn't you, Toymaker? And then just for the fun of it, the master Toymaker here decided to turn the creature into a human, her very own Inspector Marmaduke. You've discovered a means to control life. Why, you're no better than I am. Oh, la-di-da-da-da. Oh, look, I have a Christmas present for you. Don't say I never gave you anything.
Here's the machine.
Designed to look like an outhouse.
Not much of a disguise. Any child could have found it. And in fact, one did.
What have you done? Tom, may I have a little lamb? Oh, Pete, wake up, please. That's the last straw. I'd rather you to marry a man so little regard for life.
Oh, I have a lot of regard for life.
Don't try to appease me. I plan to become a widow again as soon as we're married.
I will not marry you! Not over my dead body!
I wouldn't have any other way.
Gensorgo Rodrigo, put it through the machine!
No. Stop! No! No! No!
Bon voyage!
Anyone else?
I didn't think so.
It's Orgo Media.
a good jump? Can I be a prince?
Of course you can, for as long as you live.
Did you hear that, Rodrigo? I'm gonna be a prince.
That's nice, Contrago.
Load the rest of those toy soldiers up into that machine. We'll blast a whole lot of them at once. Well, it's a bit narrow in the shoulders and not much to look at. One of the toy maker's rejects, I suppose. But as he is in the captain's uniform, I expect he'll do. This medal has a nice distinguishing touch. Rubio, hand me that medal, a hammer, and a couple nails.
Hammer? Nails?
And be quick about it. I haven't all day. Now get out of my way! Why, this doll is shaking! Probably some more for magic. Be still, fool, or I'll demote you to cabin boy! Why, this doll is alive!
Alive and well, once again.
Alan! I've forgotten all about you. No matter, you can have what's left of your insignificant inheritance and that contrary Mary. I have no need for either anymore. I have this.
Why, no, this is Mistress Mary quite that easily.
You! Indorgo, grab the book! Rodrigo, go to switch!
But I like the toys just the way they are.
Out of my way!
Destroy them! Annihilate the whole plot of them!